Hello sir, my MTP topic is Adaptive Recommendation System for MOOC. In this video, I'm going to give you a brief overview of my work. Now, this will be my outline, Introduction to the MOOC System. Then I'll be explaining about the components of Adaptive Hypermedia. Then there are two important parts in my work, which is learner modeling and knowledge representation. Then the last thing is the proposed system that I'm proposing for the new way of adaptive recommendations. Then I'll be talking about the implementation status and a plan for stage 2, and then I'll give my references. Now this one is the first slide that is giving you a brief overview of how Coursera's and EDX are working, how they are offering their courses. I think I have explained you many times about this slide. So now the thing is, we need some system which is called personalized feedback here. After this, before the deadline of any course, of any week. Now, how we are going to achieve this is through Adaptive Hypermedia. Adaptive Hypermedia is a collection of all those technologies that enables the adaptation in any sort of applications. Now, in this, I'm giving you the classification of adaptive technologies. Now, here comes the components of a typical adaptive system. Now, these systems are common in any adaptive application on the web. There are two main entities that are interacting with our system, that is designer and the learner. Learner who learns from the system, and the designer who designs the courses as well as the rules for the adaptive systems. Now, these are the most important conferences, workshops and journals across the world in this field. And among the top, UMAP is the first and the most active conference, which are basically concerned on user modeling, adaptation and personalization. Now, these are the most active people across the world who are working in this field. Now, the first part of literature survey is the learner modeling. Learner modeling is basically the understanding of a system about the user. Now, there's a difference between learner profile and a learner modeling. Learner profile is basically the learner preferences, and learner modeling is the system's understanding. There are two types of information that is stored in the learner modeling, which is the domain specific information and domain independent information. Now, this is basically the classification of learner modeling. The classification is based on two types of things, which is called the granularity and the task. Now, there are various approaches in the past for learner modeling, which is Bayesian belief network, machine learning technologies, neural network technologies, fuzzy clustering technique, neurofuzzy technique. The reason why I have studied these techniques is to answer one question, that why we need to make something new. Actually, the main the common thing in all these techniques is the learning and the need of a large amount of data set on which the system learns about the user. But in our application, in our case, we don't have that data set. Now, the first thing is the Bayesian belief network. Bayesian belief network, there are four things in this Bayesian belief network. First is the knowledge, the second is the action, evidences and utilities. That I'm giving this presentation for a brief purpose, so I'm not going into the details of Bayesian belief networks. Now, the second thing is the machine learning. A user leaves some sort of patterns while interacting with hypermedia. And by analyzing these patterns, we can understand the needs of the learner, and we can adapt the system accordingly. But there is a flaw in machine learning techniques in case of our system, because we don't have these click streams, search logs, and any sort of data set available for a particular user or for a particular participant. The only thing that we have is their preferences. Now, the neural network method, the same limitation is associated with neural network method also. Now, the next thing is the fuzzy logic method. Actually, machine learning method, we derive rules from the data. But in fuzzy logic method, we make the rule on the data. So, and fuzzy logic method are less complex than machine learning method in terms of computational complexity. Now, there are two types of clustering, hard clustering and soft clustering. I'm not going into the details. Now we need to compare all these methods to convince ourselves that which method is the best in our case. Now, there are many parameters like computational complexity, dynamic modeling, labeled and unlabeled sort of data, size of training data, uncertainty and noisy data. Now, I have compared all these techniques and figure out that fuzzy logic technique is the best suited technique in our case, because we need dynamic modeling of data and we need a technique which is less complex. Now, these are four types of adaptive task, which is called prediction, recommendation, classification and filtering. Our case, we are concentrating on this adaptation task. That's why I more concentrated on fuzzy logic techniques. Now, these are the previous systems of this kind in the past. The second part of my literature survey is the knowledge representation. We can represent our domain into various forms. Like you can see that there are four main types. Firstly, I'll be explaining about the initial thinking about the system. Then I'll be explaining about hierarchical representation, then goal-oriented connectionist knowledge representation, and then fuzzy cognitive maps. Now, initially, I thought of why don't we divide everything into concepts and on the basis of the concepts, on the basis of the quiz, we can just recommend for which concept the user marked wrong. But actually, I was wrong. Why I was wrong? Because concepts are dependent. We can exploit this dependency to achieve adaptation. First thing is, let's take an example. Concept C1 is a find the sum in the for loop. Second thing is find the average in a for loop. So we can see that there is a clear cut dependency between these two concepts. So we can exploit this dependency. Now this is the example of hierarchical knowledge representation, but there are some disadvantages associated with this. Now I came on to the fuzzy cognitive maps. Fuzzy cognitive maps are the best suited techniques in our case, because I have chosen learner modeling as a fuzzy logic technique, and the knowledge representation technique must be specific to the learner modeling technique. That's why I have chosen fuzzy cognitive maps. Now, in fuzzy cognitive maps, whole domain is divided into some concept nodes, and there is some associativity associated with these two in every two given nodes, and there is some weights also associated. On the basis of these weights, we can figure out how much the concept is dependent on another concept. Now I'll be explaining about the proposed system, what we are proposing for recommendation system in MOOCs. Now, first we need to think about what are the requirements. The first requirement, it should be adaptive. The second thing, it should be dynamic updatable, means it should be updated at a runtime. The third thing is it should have low computational complexity. And the last thing, it should be domain independent. Domain independent by means is we should not require any sort of experts to adjust the values between two given concept nodes for dependency factors. Now this one will be the two inputs to our system. First thing is exercises and the quizzes that is attempted by the participants. Now this was a high level architecture of our system. It will be a four layered architecture. First layer will consist of the lectures. Lectures are basically the set of concepts that is C1, C2, C3, and there are some sort of objectives associated with each concept, which are hierarchically arranged. And there are two types of relationships among the objectives, which I explain in the next slide. And all the objectives are related to the actual course material. Now, this one is the hierarchical representation of two concepts. The first concept is this. The second concept is this. Concept modules. There are two types of dependencies. First thing is the hierarchical relationship, and the second thing is the non-hierarchical relationship. Now, I have constructed one example of concept modules. There are six concept modules. These are the objectives associated with each concept module. Now let's take an example where this one is my first concept module, this one is my second concept module. Let's say this one is the this one is for loop and this one is the while loop, and let's say objective 4 of for loop is associated with objective 3 of while loop. Let's say objective 4 is the calculation of average in a for loop and this one is the calculation of average in a while loop. So if I know the calculation of an average in a for loop, that means system should understand that the user might know the calculation of average in a while loop. How? Let's say user attempted all those four objectives right, then system will figure out that objective 3 is most probably known to the user. It will not consider it as achieved, but it will consider as a most probable candidate for adaptation. Now I am calculating the distance of this objective to the leaf objective, that is 2. Let's say the user marked this wrong, then the system will present this objective to the user. Let's say if this is marked, then the system will understand that user must know this one, objective 2 and objective 1 also. So this one is the basic idea behind adaptation. Now this is the flow, this is the state diagram of every objective. Every objective has to go through three states. First is unattempted state, the second thing is ready state and achieved state. So an objective can go from unattempted to unattempted, then it can go from unattempted to achieved, then it can go from unattempted to ready also, and ready to unattempted also. Now this was the idea behind adaptation, but there is one more thing. We need to calculate the knowledge of a particular participant for a given concept module. So this knowledge level I have defined by some fuzzy functions. So I am giving the four fuzzy classes: unknown, partially known, and this one is the known, and this one is the learned. And the membership function for those in each four classes is defined here. Now there are three steps in my system. The first thing is the initialization. The second thing is how to update the system's assumption about a learner. The third thing is the prioritization of the concepts. The first thing is initialization. How to initialize the system? We know that we have only two sources of initialization. The first thing is the quizzes and the exercises. And we have some preferences also. So the knowledge level for a particular concept is equals to the number of objectives achieved for that concept and the total number of objectives in that concept. Now this one is an example. Let's say firstly everything is unknown to the user, and after the participant, let's say if he or she have attempted some quizzes or exercises, the system figure out that the weightage of known class is 0.2 and learned class is 0.8. So similarly for C4 and similarly for C5. So this one is the initialization part. The next thing is the prioritization of concept. How to prioritize the concept for a given participant? Now there are many approaches how to prioritize, but we need to compare all these approaches. The first thing is we can apply some topological sort. Topological sort is nothing but we need to give a given concept whose n degree is 0. For the dependency factors, there is an advantage. Select those concept modules which are affecting other concepts. We always are giving only those concepts who are making others concept as ready. There are some limitations associated with this. Now the approach 2 is select those concepts which have a minimum distance from the last ready state to the leaf node. There is also some limitations. The next thing is consider the knowledge level of a particular concept module as well as the state of the objective. Try to make from unknown to unsatisfactory known to known to learned. And similarly, we have approach 4 which can do some different patterns like unsatisfactory known to learned and to unknown. So now these are the four available approaches which I am proposing, and we need to compare all those approaches. Now I also surveyed out how to compare these approaches. Now first, let's look at what is the uniqueness of the system. The uniqueness is it is domain independent, means we don't need any experts to adjust the values between concept nodes. The second thing is we don't need any data set. The last thing is it is very less complex, only one script should be running behind the system, and the runtime updation is also possible. Now how to evaluate these approaches? Now there are some papers which tells about how to evaluate a given adaptive system. Now the basic rule from ITS community is the empirical approaches. Empirical approaches means it's the approach of basically measurement after implementation. The criteria of evaluation of the knowledge representation technique is the mean number of times that the learner is advised to read the domain concept. It sounds pretty logical, and there are some statistical approaches also, but I have not went through the details of these approaches because I was thinking about that first implement the system and after that think about the evaluation. Now these are the interfaces which I have designed in Python, taking EDX into consideration, because EDX is written into Django, and we can easily integrate these interfaces with the system. So this one is the login page, and the second will be the user interface. User interface, I am giving the recommendations in this form. Let's say these are three types of traffic lights: green light, yellow light, and red light. Green light means these concepts are ready to be learned. Yellow light means just wait some time, and the red light is take caution. So by giving this sort of sorting, I am giving the recommendation feedback to the user. Now I have not designed the user interface for course instructor till now, but I am working on that. Now this one is a preliminary use case diagram of my application. Now this one is a plan for my stage 2. In June to October, I did the literature survey part and find out the problems in existing systems. In November, I'll be doing the requirement elicitation part, the SRS document, and implementation plan. In January, I'll be doing actual implementation, the coding part, January and February. And in April, I'll be making the test plans, and I'll do testing. And in May, I'll resolve issues, deploy the system, and write a paper for UMAP if possible. So these are my references, and thank you.